Hello, I'm Mr. Anujari, retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm giving you my thoughts on pollution and the end of the age. Air is a food for your mental and physical growth. In short, technology is killing people, and foolishly, the Governments-in-Mammon are not doing much. Government is more concerned with money than with the health of the people. And air is a food, you know, for your mental food and physical growth. And if air is consumed by cars, trucks, and other things, you know, then what is left over is polluted air. That's not good for your health or your body or your mind. I lived in Ghana for 14 years in Kumasi UST University of Science and Technology campus as a lecturer in a jungle-like atmosphere. In Ghana we lived, you know, we had a bungalow which was behind the jungle, you know, and you could hear animals, you know, at night. They were howling and all that, you know. And the morning when you wake up, you get fresh air coming. And left very much healthier and strong. So my age doesn't go down, it go up, you know, rather. Used to visit Britain during the 8 weeks holidays, and I could smell foul, polluted air. So we used to come to Britain, you know, for holidays, and you could smell in the nostril, you know, the pollution. Which when you come stay here, then you don't feel it. So you can see the number of cars increasing. The health of the people is going down. They are not as healthy as used to be. So something needs to be done. In fact, we are approaching the end of this age called Kalyug, religious darkness, where greed dominates the world. And the tears, sons of Satan, Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30. The parable of farmer and wheat and tares. They are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning, expected on 14 May 2023, when atomic war could take place. Our supernatural father, God knows better. Read Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30 carefully to understand this prediction. The chosen people are nice demonstration people. They are specially planted by Yahweh in the Middle East. So if Abram was from Iraq area of Semitic race, which is a mix of Negro and Aryan, and he was planted in this promised land by Yahweh. Yahweh is the Lord of nature. In Arabic they call Khuda, and in Hindi they call it Brahma. So he planted as a demonstration nation, so it being a dark age, so through this chosen people, the nation of priests, we can learn the moral laws. A nation of priests, the moral teachers, and through them we learn our moral laws, how to live in this world of Adam Abraham equal to Adam, Sarah equal to Eve, and the promised land is Garden of Eden. Adam is called Shiv or Mahadev, noble man. Christ Jesus was the second Adam, who came to make the sons of Adam, salt of Abraham, created through baptism by John the Baptist. When John the Baptist, prophet Elijah, when he was baptizing, he baptized only Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. And he was the prophet Elijah, the cornerstone of the temple, who was ousted out by the head of the tares, head of the sons of Satan, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, who are making you outwardly, not of heart. John the Baptist are making them of heart, and outwardly, tribal people having their covenant with Abraham. Whereas the temple priests, when they make Jew outwardly, Abraham was not a Jew, he was Semitic race. So they were breaking his covenant, making tares, sons of Satan. So head of Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, whom Christ Jesus fought exposing their hypocrisy, but their blasphemer, stooges, blasphemer stooges mean what is inside, different from the mouth, as the politicians are, killed him by shouting against him to the Pilate. So these days, you know, more the voices and more effective it is. So that's why the temple priests, you know, they break all their stooges to shout for the death of Jesus. So very few people who were giving the good that he healed me and this and that, there were very few of them. Gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. It's not that cheap. So Christ Jesus turned salt of the earth, sons of man produced by John the Baptist, the builders that rejected the temple high priest, into the sons of God, called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., our supernatural father of our souls. So Jesus turned sons of man produced by John the Baptist, when he baptized them in the name of Abraham, and Jesus himself was baptized in the name of his heavenly father, Yahweh. Today the religious fanatics, the tares, not planted by the heavenly father Yahweh or Yeshua, heavenly father Yahweh of Yeshua. That was the Hebrew name of Jesus. It's Yeshua stand for Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva, the primal Adam, born of his surrogate mother, Mary, and cared by his foster father, Joseph of the Judah tribe, are those who have sweared their tribal links. They will kill and burn each other. Every plot, a plot means person, that my heavenly father Yahweh did not plant or has sweared his tribal link, shall be uprooted, killed on a massive scale along with the roots, the fanatic supporters. So if you want to live in peace of Adam, then establish your covenant with Adam through your tribal fathers. I will make a YouTube video on this topic, which I'm doing, so that you can understand. Now, we were in Pakistan area during partition of India. and we were told to move out into India side. So 2,000 people came to attack our village, and when my father explained to the attacking head that Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self, never born, never die. We tribal people do it to kill each other. So if you have any enmity between the tribes, then we can settle it. And the head of the attacking party said, we are friends, we are no enmity. So when he understood the underlying mischief by the shopkeepers, then he told my father, let's go to Lahore, capital of Punjab, to stop this partition. And he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did. So this is the power of gospel. So gospel is not common. It is by the grace of our Father you get it. So it's up to you, you know, to earn his grace by cleaning this temple of greed. What is inside should be outside, like little children. No hypocrisy at all. Then you can preach gospel from your own heart. When you have pondered over it, logically, that brews logo. Our Father God blesses everyone alike.